Okay, hello, welcome to my second Apple and Milk and Tea video. In the first one, we discussed the flora and fauna that Apple and Milk and Tea adds, and now, once we have gathered our resources, we're going to talk about how to process them. So you've got these machines the very first thing that you'll need is not a machine, it's a tool, it's called the grater. This will work in the same way as the food processor, but it's generally less efficient than the food processor is. So, for example, if you put 3 wheat in here, now in this mod, wheat is rice. Minecraft is a game about your imagination, so use your imagination, pretend those are rice stalks. If we put 3 of them with the grater, we'll get 1 washed rice. There's a lot of things that you're going to use the grater for. One thing that I really like about this mod, and it's minor, but it's really useful. You know, in Minecraft, a lot of times you'll have a ton of sheep, you'll be able to shear them, you'll have 8,000 wool, and you'll never be able to get enough string, because spiders are a lot harder to come by. There you go. You can grate your wool, turn it into string. It's great! So that is the grater. After you have graduated from the grater, you will make the food processor. The food processor will take power. So we'll talk about the power options for powering. Several of the machines will take power, and they'll all use these resources. So the first one that you will never use, but it is in the game, it's called the manual charge generator. It's a crank, and each time you click it, it generates 20 RF. And the reason you will never use this is because 20 RF is a very tiny amount. And if you put in one of these yuzu fruits, that will add 80 RF. So that is 4 clicks of that crank for adding one little yuzu fruit there. So definitely recommend starting with that one and ignoring the crank. The next level up will be the citrus battery, and that'll be 800, so that's worth 10 plain yuzu, or just, I don't know, about 10 billion, I think, if I have the math right here, cranks on that annoying little crank thing. I will mention the citrus battery recipe, because this is a little bit tricky. You notice that the very first recipe is a gold nugget and an iron nugget. And notice that this iron nugget is not changing. You must use an apple and milk and tea iron nuggets, even if you have a mod that adds other iron nuggets. So, if you go into your crafting grid, and you put an iron ingot in there, you would get 9 iron nuggets, but these are from garden stuff. They will not work on your citrus battery. You try to put them in there, you'll get nothing. You need to use the grater to grate your iron ingot to make an apple and milk and tea iron nugget, and then you can make your citrus battery. Once you have that, like I said, 800, you can put that in there. The top two levels of power are pretty similar. They're the battery and the advanced disposable battery. You cannot make these. You have to find them in dungeon chests. And they have a lot of charge. I've never actually found the advanced in dungeon chests, but the regular battery is very, very common. And, you know, explore a couple of dungeons, you'll have enough power to last you forever, pretty much. So once you put it in there... Oh, it's too much. Like, it won't even take it right now because it would overfill the food processor. So once this goes down enough that battery could go in there, it would power it up. The other quick notes about the food processor that you need to know. One, because you can use the yuzu fruit as a power source, and you can also use it to make recipes... if you shift-click to try to make your grated lime in there, it will automatically put it in the power slot, and you'll say, oh no, I lost my yuzu! Ah, no grated lime. You actually have to pick it up and click it in the processing slot to get it to make grated lime. The other thing is that all these recipes are shapeless. So, for example, we have this one here that is an apple, sugar, and boiled rice to make ale yeast, and we have this one here that's an apple to make grated apple. When you're making your ale yeast, do not put the apple in first, because it will start making grated apple. Put the sugar, the boiled rice in, and then it won't start processing until you have the whole recipe in there. A couple recipes like that, so just be aware of those. That is it for the... the other thing. I was going to demonstrate how the food processor is more efficient than the grater is. So if we put 1 wheat in here, that will turn into 1 washed rice. So instead of taking 3 wheat to make 1 washed rice, it now only takes 1. That's a great savings. So you wind up going very quickly with that. Let's take our tea leaves and put them in the food processor. and get ourselves some green tea leaves, and this is what we can use on the tea maker. The tea maker, again, to make your teas, you can use your crafting grid. Most of them are a water bottle or a water bucket. The tea ingredient, which you can find in NEI, you can look up all the different things that you can make teas out of, and an empty mug, an empty teacup. If you do it that way, one ingredient makes one cup, so it's not very efficient. But you can do it when you're out adventuring and you need a quick potion. There you go. You can make yourself a little pick-me-up on the road. If you're at home, though, and you use your tea maker, one ingredient makes a whole pot of tea. It doesn't take any power. All you do is right-click with the ingredient, makes the whole thing. Then you will right-click with your empty teacup, and boom. You have your lovely tea, which you can then... and get a potion effect. In this case, I made green tea, so it gave me 30 seconds of haste. If you decide that you don't want to drink all your tea, all the machines this work this way. If you break them, they will lose whatever ingredients they had in them. Don't need two of those. They will keep any charge, however, so you don't have to worry about, like, breaking your charged up machines and losing all that power. They'll just reset the ingredients. So you can make a whole new pot of tea now. You can just throw out that old tea. The next machine we'll talk about is the ice maker. This one may be a little tricky because it's not actually an ice maker. I think that's a bad translation. It's really more like an ice cream maker. It's not powered. You actually fill it with ice and then it chills whatever ingredients you put in there. So in this case I'll put in some condensed milk. Let's do a couple of them. And it will make some ice cream. The ice creams are, again, just like everything that you can eat or drink in this mod, they have potion effects. So they are very useful. They're a nice way. They fill you up and give you something good. So we'll talk about how to eat the foods in this mod, because if I just right-click here, you notice I did not eat it. I set it down on that block. So the first and most efficient way to eat things, if you're at home and feeling civilized, you can pull a chopstick out of your chopsticks holder, right-click with the chopsticks on the item, and you've eaten it instantly. So now I've got my minute and a half of fire resistance. Put those back. If I'm not at home, or I just feel like, you know, eating with my face, you can either point at a point where there's no block that you can interact with, so point at the sky is generally the easiest thing to do, and right click, and that will eat. Or an apple won't work well. Anyway, you can shift and right click, and that will also eat the food. Those are important because if you just try to right click like normal Minecraft, you'll just wind up throwing all your food on the ground, and that'll be awkward. The food, you can place it on DecoCraft tables. You cannot place it on BiblioCraft tables, so just be aware of that if you're using those mods. The next machine we'll talk about is the Hyperjaw Crusher. That one's out here. It is a way of doubling your ores, pretty much, and sometimes tripling them. You can see that one had, I'd stuck an iron ore in there, and it gave me an extra one. This one is also a little iffy working with other mods. Sometimes it will create other mods that add dusts, and sometimes it won't. I'm not quite sure what, you know, I'm sure it just has something to do with the dictionary thing, but it's not a perfect integration. So if you can use it, it's generally a really efficient way to double, and again, sometimes triple your ores, so that's nice. And then you smelt those just like you would smelt ores in vanilla Minecraft. So there it is. You'll also make sawdust in here, which you'll need later on. And then the last machine, well, we'll go ahead and talk about it. This is the charger block. So there is an item called the Yuzu Gatling Gun. It's super fun. There it is. It is, you know, a small little sidearm. Very cute. So it's in there, and you'll make it, and you'll go to shoot it, and you'll realize it will not work. And the reason it won't work is because you need to charge it up. This should work with anything that takes RF that can be charged, but again, the integration might be a little iffy. You could definitely try because you have a ton of slots in here and you could charge a bunch of things at once. It also takes a bunch of power. You can fit just lots and lots of power in there, so if you have extra batteries, you can just throw them in there. Once your gun is charged, then you can try it again. And you realize that, oh, nope, it won't work because you need ammunition, which in this case is yuzu fruits. Yuzu fruits. There they are. Okay. So once you have some of those, let's get a volunteer to help with our demonstration here. You can shoot away. It's not super strong as guns go, but it does have a pretty good range on it. And you can kill things eventually. One more weapon that this mod adds is the Black Onyx Sword. This one is very tricky. We'll see if I can get it to work. So, put my skeleton down. Hello? Stay in the house, dude. Hello? Where are you going? Hello, friend? Alright, so... Oops. There. No. Alright, so... I wait for him to try to shoot me. I let go. And, yeah, this, as I mentioned, the timing is very tricky. Right on here. There we go. If you get the timing right, you will get 1.5 seconds of this effect called reflex, reflex 3. That is reflection, so any damage that a mob does to you, it'll do back to it. As you saw, I'm not particularly skilled in that, so if you don't want to do that, other option is to just hit things with the sword, and it's slightly more powerful than having a sword. So there you go. There's always that. And that is the Onyx Sword. It's actually very cheap to make. It's made with onyx, which is basically just processed flint. You'll need to gather it up and cook it and that kind of thing. And one piece of iron. So it is cheaper than a diamond sword, and again, tiny but more powerful. So it's a very useful thing to have in your arsenal. A good early game weapon. Now we will take a break, and when we come back, we'll go over cooking with the oven and the